Dear students, good morning. I'm Dr. Pratibha Jadhav and I'm your chemistry faculty, and we are starting now our unit 4 fuels. Last Monday we completed our first session and today we are starting our second session. Like the previous session, in this session also there are parts like 1, 2, 3, etc. We will continue today our fourth unit fuel. I have given here my mobile number, and after our session you can call me or send me messages if you have any doubts. Okay, so we are starting and we will continue our next point now. After bomb colorimeter we are starting, next point is Boyle's colorimeter. Okay, we get gross calorific value of solid or liquid fuel by bomb colorimeter. Now we can get gross calorific value of gaseous fuels and highly volatile liquid fuels by using Boyle's colorimeter. Okay, now what is the meaning of volatile liquids? The volatile liquids which evaporates at room temperature or which vaporizes easily. Okay, volatile liquids, the liquid which easily evaporates. Okay, what are example of volatile liquids? Volatile liquids examples are petrol, acetone, alcohols. Okay, so we can get gross calorific value of gaseous fuels and highly volatile liquids by using Boyle's colorimeter. Okay, so first is principle of Boyle's colorimeter. Gaseous fuel is burnt at a known constant rate. Okay, gaseous fuel is burnt at a known constant rate in the colorimeter under such conditions that the entire amount of heat liberated by combustion of fuel is absorbed by the water circulating in the colorimeter. Okay, what is principle? When gaseous fuel is burnt, right? When gaseous fuel is burnt in the colorimeter, at that time heat liberated, the amount of heat liberated by combustion of fuel is absorbed by the water circulating in the colorimeter. Okay, so heat evolved and it is absorbed. Heat evolved by combustion of fuel and heat is absorbed by the water circulating in the colorimeter. This is the principle of Boyle's colorimeter. We use Boyle's colorimeter to find out the gross calorific value of gaseous fuels. Again, we know what is gross calorific value, right? So this is a diagram of Boyle's colorimeter. Dear students, the diagram is seems too difficult, but you can have to draw this gas burner, right? Then you can have to draw this insulating chamber, you can have to show this inner coils and outer coils, and you can have to show this exhaust gases inlet, water inlet and the condensed steam here, and this is the water outlet. Okay, so you can draw this diagram as a skeleton also, not necessary jaisa diagram dikha hai waha pe waise nahi draw kiya to bhi chalega, aap log skeleton dikha sakte ho waha pe. Okay, and this diagram is very easy to draw, right? So next we are starting, the construction of Boyle's colorimeter. Okay, in Boyle's colorimeter there are main four important parts. Which are these parts? First is gas burner. This is a gas burner. This is first part. Second is combustion chamber. This is a combustion chamber. Okay. Next, third, these two thermometers, thermometer 1 and thermometer 2, and the insulating cover. This is the insulating cover. Okay. These are the four parts of construction of Boyle's colorimeter. Okay, so I am explaining one by one. First is gas burner. This is gas burner. The gas here should burn at the rate of 3 to 4 liter per minute. The gas should burn at the rate of 3 to 4 liter per minute. Okay, now second, there is a combustion chamber. Okay, this is a combustion chamber, right? Now, around this gas burner, there is a combustion chamber, and in this combustion chamber, there are two copper tubing coils. There are two copper tubing coils. Okay, this is the inner copper coil. This is the inner copper coil, and this is the outer copper coil. Okay, so in this chamber, in this combustion chamber, there are two copper tubing coils. One is inside and one is outside. Now, water enters from this top of the outer coil. Water enters from this top of outer coil. Water enters from this top of outer coil, and it moves at the bottom. It moves at the bottom of the chimney, and then it goes upward from the, then it goes upward through the inner coil, and it goes upward through the inner coil to exist at the top. Okay, to exist at the top. This is a combustion chamber. Next, third parts are thermometer. This is first thermometer and this is second thermometer. These thermometers are to measure the temperatures of inlet water and outlet water. Okay. Now, the next and the last part is insulating cover. This is a insulating cover. Okay. This insulating cover, what is its role here? Its role to detach this combustion chamber from the atmosphere. This insulating chamber detach this combustion chamber from atmosphere. Okay, again, you can see there is a hole. You can see there is a hole for exhaust gases at the top. Okay, then there is water inlet at the top. And at the bottom here, you can see, at the bottom here, you can see this condensed steam. At the bottom, you can see this condensed steam. Okay. At the bottom, you can see this condensed steam. Now, next is, what is working of Boyle's colorimeter? Okay. You will start burning the gas. This gas, we will burn at suitable pressure, and we will adjust the rate of water flow such that the temperature of outgoing water, the temperature of outgoing water remains constant. ओके देखो यहाँ पे हम लोगों को बर्निंग ऑफ गैस स्टार्ट करना है, और हम लोगों को यहाँ जो वाटर का फ्लो रेट है उसका जो टेम्परेचर है, ओके, तो उसका टेम्परेचर हम लोगों को कॉन्स्टेंट रखना है. वी विल बर्न दिस गैस फॉर 5 to 10 मिनट्स. 5 to 10 मिनट्स के लिए हम लोग गैस बर्न करेंगे, सो दैट वी कैन हैव स्टेडी टेम्परेचर ऑफ आउटगोइंग वाटर. बर्न करेंगे गैस 5 to 10 मिनट्स, सो दैट हम लोगों को ये जो वाटर है जो बाहर जा रहा है उसका टेम्परेचर स्टेडी हो जाएगा. ओके, नाउ विच कंडीशंस आर स्टेडी हियर? आउटगोइंग